Sight and Sound welcomes you to this special live broadcast event. Join the cast, crew, and director as we go behind the scenes of this debut feature film. I Heard the Bells. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your host, Katie Miller.
Good evening, everyone. We are live from the world premiere of Sight and Sound's debut film, I Heard the Bells. My name is Katie Miller, and it is my absolute privilege to welcome you to our red carpet celebration. This theater is full of the Sight and Sound team, cast, crew, and partners that came together to produce this film. After 2 years of production, this incredible group of people gets to watch it for the very first time, and you can feel the anticipation in the room. We are also so grateful to be welcoming you, our virtual audience, to celebrate with us. Tonight, we want to take you behind the scenes of this inspiring film. We're going to meet the cast and get a first glimpse at a never-before-released scene. But first, for those of you not familiar with Henry Longfellow's life, here's a brief look at the heart of this story.
I Heard the Bells is a story about the famous Christmas song by the title, I Heard the Bells on Christmas Day, by America's most famous poet, Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. It's a Civil War story. And this is a story of a man who experiences tragedy, who could have and should have lost all hope and everything. And it was through the bell that hangs at the steeple, that rings out across the land, it was through that symbol that God spoke to his heart and said, then pealed the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor does he sleep. This film is about hope. It's about new hope. And so this story really celebrates how God is with us in those tragedies and makes us an incredible voice for him because of the tragedies.
I Heard the Bells is coming to movie theaters nationwide in just 2 weeks, and we are bursting with excitement to share this incredible story with you. To start us off tonight, I'd like to introduce you to two of the lead actors in the film, Steve Atherholt and Jonathan Blair. Hi, guys.
Hey,
thanks
Katie.
For being with us.
Absolutely.
I'm so happy to have you here. We're so excited for tonight. We can't wait. Steve, I'm going to start with you. You play Henry Wadsworth Longfellow in the film, and he is a complex and challenging character to represent. So can you talk to us about Henry a little bit?
Absolutely. It was an honor to be able to play Henry. Yeah. I mean, he was America's famous poet of his time, the most famous poet of his time. And as a poet, he really experienced life to the fullest. Yeah. I think that creative aspect of who he was enabled him to see the world in a depth and a perspective that I think a lot of people may miss. But part of being a poet and being able to see that depth is to be experiencing life to the fullest in every moment. And that includes like really, really high highs.
Yeah.
Time with his family and his son. And he really took that all in and lived life just as full as he possibly could. While at the same time, the depths of tragedy, I think, impacted him in ways that, well, you know, when you lose someone you love, it's possible you yourself can get lost.
Yeah.
And I think that's part of his story. But it's not the end of his story,
right.
Which is amazing. You know, we serve a God who specializes in resurrection. And so to see his heart be resurrected by the power of the Lord was amazing to be a part of. The journey itself was really hard as an actor in that character and the filming, but we had so many beautiful moments and creative memories together that we'll never forget.
Yeah, and his story is one I think we all can identify with in many different ways.
Yeah.
Jonathan, you play Charlie Longfellow, Henry's son, and you've also played many roles here on the Sight and Sound stage, but you said you had a special connection to Charlie, so can you talk to us about that a little bit?
Definitely. I relate to Charlie so easily because, like so many young people, he's just hungry for a chance to prove to himself and to others that he has what it takes to succeed. And when we have that mindset, sometimes we can rush into situations, or in Charlie's case, battles, that we're not equipped to handle. Yeah. And we find out we really don't have what it takes to succeed. And I think Charlie discovers, as I've discovered in my life, that our character is defined by how we choose to respond to that reality.
And it's an incredible part of the story. Steve, what was your favorite part of this process?
Oh, hands down, the people. I've shot a lot in a lot of different places, and working with Sight and Sound, with this cast, with the costume department, and just working with everybody along the way, all the way from the top, from Josh Hank and his vision, and holding loosely this beautiful thing that he wanted to create, all the way through the make and the different teams that we got to work with, and the lighting and the audio. It's just everyone came with a heart to give, with a heart to be obedient to what we were called to do in this process. And just wonderful people. We created a lot of great memories together, and it was so much fun.
Yeah, you guys were an awesome part of it and a huge part of leading that process too. Jonathan, tonight we are going to watch a never-before-released scene from the film. Do you want to set it up for us?
Absolutely. So this was probably the most fun day on set, one of them at least, because this was definitely the most people we had at any given time. We had hundreds of extras, cast, crew, all coming together to bring this scene, this parade, from the time of the Civil War. So it's the height of the Civil War. Henry has promised to his wife that he'll keep his sons out of harm's way at all costs, but that's not Charlie's idea of the way he wants his life to go. Yeah. So the scene we're about to watch, he makes a bold decision.
No. Guys, thank you so much. You both bring so much heart and authenticity to this film. We're so excited for tonight. I know you guys are too. Thank you for being with us.
Absolutely.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, everybody, take a first look at this never before shared scene from the film.
Sir, here.
Charlie.
Charlie.
Next up.
Sign your name here and sign your name there.
You Longfellow's boy.
I am.
Suddenly a man? Next up.
The boys will. Yes, the winds will.
Friends, if you're just tuning in, we are live from the red carpet at the world premiere of I Heard the Bells, coming to movie theaters nationwide in just 2 weeks. This theater is full of the Sight and Sound team, cast, crew, and partners who cannot wait to get their first look at this film. Right now, I'm joined by Rachel Day Hughes, who plays Henry's wife, Fanny, in the movie. Hi, Rachel.
Hi.
Thank you for being here. We're so excited.
I'm so excited, too.
So Fanny's character brings so much light and life to this film. So talk to us a little bit about Fanny.
Oh, I would love to. Fanny Longfellow was such a dynamic woman. She was an artist. She was a literary genius in her own right. She had fierce convictions, but she also experienced big changes of heart. Probably most notably is the fact that it took Henry 7 years to convince her to marry him. And of course she did, and their story is beautiful, but she's warm and she's humble, but she's also a woman of great strength.
And you did a lot of research as you were getting ready to perform the role. So talk to us tell us a little bit about what you discovered.
Yes, I was so thrilled to find this one particular book. It's called Mrs. Longfellow, and it was a collection of firsthand writings that Fanny had done from her entire life. So letters and journal entries. it was like a treasure trove for an actor because I felt like I was experiencing the events of their story through her eyes. And in it was this beautifully written account of the moment that Fanny came to faith. And this really did happen, and it really did happen on Christmas Day. And so I'm so pleased and honored that we get to honor her tonight by sharing her exact words with the world through this film.
It's just an unbelievable story on so many different levels. Did you have a favorite part of playing this role?
Oh, my goodness. I really can't choose. What a cop-out. But the whole thing was so enchanting and fulfilling. It was a great honor. I mean, the costumes were stunning, and being on set felt like we had time traveled. I got to sing, I got to dance, I got to play a mom, which is so near to my heart. The whole thing was just such a gift.
Yeah. After audiences watch this film, do you have something they hope that they walk away with?
Yes. You know, the final words of the song are "Peace on earth, goodwill to men." And those are not original to Henry.
Yeah.
They are scripture.
Yeah.
And they're the whole reason why we celebrate Christmas is because Christ actually did come to give us peace on earth in the midst of grief, hope in the midst of loss. And so if there's anyone out there that is walking a journey of grief this Christmas, it's my hope that as you watch Henry struggle to reclaim and rekindle the truth of those words over his story, that you would be inspired to do the same.
It's beautiful. Rachel, thank you so much.
Yes.
You are stunning in the film. I hope you enjoy your night tonight.
Oh, thank you so much.
Have a good night. While this isn't a musical, it is a movie about a song, and we recorded an original version soon to be released wherever you listen to music. Here's an exclusive first listen and look at this beautiful carol.
Yeah.
We are winding down this red carpet celebration as we get closer to the premiere event. For our final guest, please welcome Josh Enk, Chief Story Officer and Director of I Heard the Bells. Hello.
Hello, Katie. Here we are.
Here we are. There is literally nothing else to say.
Yes, we're standing.
We're standing.
We're standing.
We're
here.
And we're excited.
So excited.
So this is Sight and Sound's first film.
That's right.
For those tuning in, tell them why this story.
Wow. Well, Sight and Sound Films is set out to tell the stories of figures and events from history that have changed the world because Christ first changed them. This is about inspiring stories from our past. And we want to do a Christmas story, and when we put those two things together, the one that rose to the top was to tell a true story about a beloved song, I Heard the Bells on Christmas Day. It's a Civil War era film. It just kind of checked all those boxes, and it felt like the one that the Lord wanted us to do first, also just to kind of be that bell to ring out, you know, and to sound the voice of Christmas and the story of hope.
Yeah, and we're so excited
that it's
finally here.
Yes.
So from directing, writing, days on set, post-production, what was your favorite part of this entire experience?
Oh my goodness. Well, okay, so when you get that idea and you know that it's the idea that's going to really inspire the masses, that's quite a feeling. Mm-hmm. And that's a very intimate and personal time that I've experienced with the Lord. And so that's a really tough emotion and time to beat. But what does beat that is when that vision then is created and given to and cast to the rest of the people. And then everybody assembles around, and you get a whole army of Sight and Sound employees, and in this case, some outside contractors who caught that vision, carried it together, and then landed the plane. That collaboration, that collaborative spirit is impossible to beat, especially when you're doing it with the center of being about Christ and inspiring people for eternity.
Right, and you feel it in the final product of this film. Yeah. Like, it just radiates from the stage.
Yeah.
So how do you feel tonight?
I should say stage. How do I feel? My goodness, you know, there are so many emotions going on right now. This is a two-year journey, almost to the day, actually.
Yeah.
And a lot of incredible experiences, a lot of God stories, a lot of miracles along the way, some challenges along the way. This is a fast-paced production process. We've never done this before. This is our very first movie. And so for us, it was just kind of like getting our feet underneath us and then realizing, hey, wait a minute. I think we're onto something very special here.
Yeah.
And I think we are. And so I think tonight is going to be an experience for everybody to say, oh, they're serious. Sight and Sound Films is for real.
Right.
And I think they're going to love it.
Yeah. Well, I'm so excited for what's to come.
Yeah.
And speaking of excited, in 2 weeks, it's going to be in movie theaters nationwide.
Yes.
And we have a lot of really excited people ready to watch this film. What do you hope they experience when they walk out of that theater at the end of the night?
When they walk out of the movie theaters nationwide, it's going to be around Christmas time, obviously.
Yeah.
And so I think their hearts are going to be fertile and ready to hear something that's in line with who we are and Christ-centered. And I think they're going to walk out of this, out of the show, the film, believing that, hey, if God can use Henry Longfellow through all of his crisis, all the tragedies, and he can still be a voice, then I can too. And that's what I really want people to realize is that, you know, when life's tragedies come our way, that's not a time to be silent. That's a time to be a voice like the bell and ring out truth more loud and deep, just like the story, like the song says.
Yeah.
And so I hope that they have a charged hope, a new hope, coming into the new season.
Awesome. Thank you. We're all
Thank
so
you,
excited. We're excited to be here tonight. Thank you so much for joining us. I Heard the Bells is coming to movie theaters nationwide starting December 1st. Theaters are already selling out, and we are overwhelmed with gratitude for the support from each of you. On behalf of all of us here at Sight and Sound, thank you for letting us be a part of your Christmas season. We can't wait to see you there. Good night.
Good night.